जीके किड्स।
द टू हेडेड वीवर। वंस अपॉन अ टाइम देयर लिव्ड अ वीवर नेम्ड मनोहर इन अ विलेज। मोस्ट ऑफ हिज वीविंग टूल्स वर मेड ऑफ वुड। वन डे देयर वॉज हैवी रेनफॉल कॉजिंग वॉटर टू फ्लड हिज हाउस। Due to this, his weaving machine got completely damaged. Manohar became very worried because if he didn't fix his machine soon, he wouldn't be able to weave clothes and his family would go hungry. With this thought, Manohar decided to go to the forest to find good wood to repair his machine. He set out towards the forest with this idea in mind. He walked all day but couldn't find any good wood for his machine. Still, Manohar didn't give up and continued searching for a good tree. After a long search, he finally spotted a tall, thick, green tree. He thought, "Yes, this tree looks good. Its wood will help me fix my machine." With this thought, Manohar raised his axe to cut the tree, but suddenly a deity appeared on the tree's branch. The deity told Manohar, "I reside in this tree and find peace here. So, it wouldn't be right for you to cut this tree. Besides, cutting any green tree is not acceptable." Upon hearing the deity's words, Manohar apologized and said, "Oh deity, I am helpless. I need to cut this tree to fix my machine. I have searched a lot, and this tree is my last hope. If I don't cut this tree, my machine will remain broken, and my family will go hungry. That's why I have to do this." Listening to Manohar's plea, the deity said, "Manohar, I am pleased with your honesty. Instead of cutting this tree, you can ask for a boon from me, and I will fulfill your wish." Hearing this, Manohar thought for a while and said, "Oh deity, I want to consult with my friend and wife about the boon. Please give me a day to decide." The deity agreed to Manohar's request and gave him a day to think. The next day, on his way home, Manohar met his friend, the barber. He told the barber about the boon from the deity. The barber advised him to ask for a kingdom. He said, "Ask for a kingdom from the deity. You become the king and I'll become the minister. Then we won't have any troubles and we can live our lives comfortably." On hearing the barber's advice, Manohar said, "Friend, you are absolutely right. Let me also ask my wife for advice on this matter, and then I will ask for the boon from the deity." However, the barber warned Manohar not to ask for his wife's opinion as she was arrogant and foolish, thinking only about her benefits. Manohar replied, "Still, she is my wife, so I will definitely ask for her opinion." With these words, Manohar continued towards his home. When he reached home, he narrated the entire incident that happened in the forest to his wife. Upon hearing about the boon from the deity, Manohar's wife said, "Asking for a kingdom won't bring any benefits. A king has many responsibilities and often lives a life filled with sorrow. Even great kings like Rama and Nala suffered despite being rulers. You are already skilled in weaving and earning well. If you had two heads and four hands, you could weave twice the clothes, doubling your income, and your reputation would also increase in society." Manohar understood his wife's point and went back to the forest to meet the deity. Upon meeting the deity again, Manohar asked for two heads and four hands. The deity asked him what he would do with two heads and four hands. Manohar explained that with two heads and four hands, he could weave twice the clothes, doubling his income. The deity smiled and granted Manohar's wish. With the boon, Manohar became very happy and headed back home. However, when he reached the village, the children playing there got scared seeing him and thought of him as a monster. Some villagers, armed with weapons, attacked Manohar, leading to his death. When Manohar's wife heard about his death, she cried and blamed herself for everything. She said, "All this is my fault. I was the one who asked him to seek the boon from the deity. If I hadn't, today no one would have mistaken Manohar for a monster, and he would have been alive. The moral of the story, the weaver with two heads, teaches us that any action taken without careful consideration always leads to sorrow.